The focus of this talk is the automation and integration of LC-MS/MS assays into the workflow of a clinical laboratory. The talk will include a background of the laboratory services at Imperial College Healthcare and an overview of the steps that we have taken to streamline our LC-MS/MS services. These steps come under three broad areas of reducing manual processes, improving integration, and increasing throughput. Imperial College Healthcare is a network of five hospitals in northwest London, serving a population of 2 million, and there are over 1 million patient episodes per annum across the hospitals of our trust. There are 10,000 employees, of whom 1,000 are healthcare scientists. And across all the pathology disciplines, we process over 15 million specimens per year. As part of the networking and consolidation of pathology services in England, as of the 1st of April 2017, we have formed Northwest London Pathology. This is a consortium of pathology laboratories hosted by Imperial Healthcare NHS Trust in partnership with two other NHS trusts. Our labs cover six hospitals with one hub lab and five spoke laboratories. LC-MS/MS services at Imperial include the immunosuppressant monitoring lab at Hammersmith Hospital, specialist hospital in our network, where there is also an interest in hemoglobinopathies. The specialist endocrine laboratory is based in the hub laboratory at Charing Cross Hospital, where we have five LC-MS/MS instruments. The specialist endocrine service has been a supra-regional assay service since 1974. This is an organisation of approximately 60 diagnostic labs, which are centres of excellence offering analytical and clinical expertise in specific specialised diagnostic investigations. We offer the analysis of steroid and peptide hormones, initially using in-house developed RIA methodology. The peptide hormones offered include insulin, C-peptide and gut hormones. We also offer renin activity, aldosterone and several other steroid hormones. It is these assays we've been focusing on transitioning over to LC-MS/MS in recent years. So why move to LC-MS/MS? Well, the technique offers a number of advantages over the more traditional immunoassay, including increased specificity, sensitivity and accuracy, the enabling of the detection of multiple analytes in a single assay, there is no need for an antibody for analyte detection, and the method is not susceptible to the antibody-based interferences which plague immunoassays. The technique is suitable for multiple sample matrices and avoids the need for radioactive tracers. LC-MS/MS has seen over two decades of use in specialist clinical labs in the UK, initially playing a role in newborn screening and inborn errors of metabolism, but also playing its part in toxicology, immunosuppressant and therapeutic drug monitoring. Its role in specialist endocrinology is more recent, with the first appearance of LC-MS/MS for the measurement of vitamin D in the international DQAS EQA scheme in 2005. There are now over 150 labs registered in this scheme, and we're using LC-MS/MS for the measurement of vitamin D. However, automated immunoassays still dominates and represents 69% of participants registered in the DQAS scheme. So why has there not been more widespread adoption? There are a number of barriers to the routine adoption and use of LC-MS/MS in the clinical lab. These include the need for often manual labour-intensive workflows, giving lower throughput, decreased productivity and longer turnaround time. Technical expertise is needed for both method development and troubleshooting the assays when things go wrong. And as well as the high initial capital cost of purchasing the equipment, the ongoing personnel costs are higher due to the need for technically competent staff. So how can we overcome some of these barriers? If we consider the typical LC-MS/MS workflow, from sample receipt through to extraction, separation in the LC, MS/MS analysis, and following some review of the data, the reporting of the results. It is the pre- and post-analytical stages that are the most time-consuming. And therefore, if we focus on streamlining these, maximum benefit can be achieved. So how can we streamline the workflow? This is possible in three main areas. Firstly, we can reduce manual processes by introducing automated liquid handling and extraction and using barcode reading for worklist generation. We can improve integration by interfacing our LC-MS/MS system to the laboratory IT system. And we can use this for worklist upload and results download. Finally, we can increase throughput with improved sample management and analyte multiplexing. To reduce manual processes, we can implement automated liquid handling procedures for the pipetting of samples and the addition of internal standard. And this allows some of the steps of liquid-liquid extraction to be automated. By using supported liquid extraction in a 96 well plate format, which offers a diatomaceous earth inert support for the liquid extraction process, we can fully automate our supported liquid extraction. And this instrument shown here enables pipetting of samples, addition of internal standards, and full automation of all the steps of SLE. Finally, we have automated SPE, and this platform shown here is able to pipette the samples at the internal standards and carry out all the steps required for solid phase extraction. If we move on to consider improved integration, here we are talking about bidirectional interfacing of the laboratory information management system to the MassLinks software on the LC-MS/MS. This occurs via a MassLinks LIMS interface, which enables both worklist download and results upload. The MassLinks LIMS interface is accessed via target links and allows direct transmission between MassLinks and a third-party LIMS via an HL7 interface. This avoids the need for manual transcription and saves a lot of staff time. By partnering with a company called CSOLS, we were able to implement a system whereby we could have automatic worklist generation. The mass spec to be used is selected. The method is selected, in this case, Aldostero, and this opens up a pre-populated worklist which already has the standards and QCs in the desired positions. Samples are added to this worklist by barcode scanning. The worklist is then saved and can be imported into the MassLinks software on the LC-MS/MS instrument. And here we see an imported run ready for analysis. When the analysis is complete, the interface is accessed again, the run is selected, and the results can be transmitted to the LIMS. A confirmatory message appears in the lower window pane when this is complete. We can then go to the LIMS to enable results release. And here we see a batch of samples awaiting release. It is a batch of vitamin D samples, and the results can be released from here. In this example, we see a batch of 17 hydroxyprogesterones and androstenediones. Each result can be reviewed in turn, and any clinical comments can be added accordingly prior to release of the results. If we consider our assay repertoire at Imperial, we initially had a number of standalone assays, including vitamin D and several steroid hormones. The acquisition of the automated SPE platform enabled us to transfer aldosterone and renin activity assays over to LC-MS/MS. And with the planned addition of further steroids into our repertoire and the need to transfer further RIA methods over to our LC-MS/MS instruments, we began to ask how we could increase throughput. Increased throughput can be achieved through the use of column and sample managers, which allows multiple runs to be queued up for overnight analysis of different assays. LC multiplexing enables multiple columns to be coupled to one tandem mass spec system. And finally, we have analyte multiplexing, which can use manufacturer's kits or in-house laboratory developed tests. So to conclude, LC-MS/MS automation and integration is now a reality, allowing faster sample processing and improved turnaround time, offering increased staff productivity, improved quality, and reduced error rate. Staff time has been liberated for further service development, which has allowed us to implement full method-validated methods, which are robust and are ISO 15189 compliant. We are an ISO 15189 accredited laboratory, having first been assessed for this in 2015.